This is going to be a short and sweet review of my two AK-74s. On top we have Polish Tantal. On bottom we have Russian Saiga SGL31. I want to warn everybody that this is a very dangerous video. You should probably send your kids out of the room, put on body armor. I mean, do what you need to do because these magazines are loaded. This one here has some hollow points in it. So, I mean, I don't know what to tell you, but I don't keep my guns unloaded. There's no bullet in the chamber. However, the magazines are loaded. So this is a very, very dangerous video. You might need to flag it, get it removed, call the local authorities, do whatever you need to do, but these two magazines are loaded right now. This is a very dangerous situation. Now anyways, so Polish Tantal, very nice, very cheap, $430. I think right now you can get them for about $399 from jgsells.com. Very reliable gun. Has a folding stock. Comes in very handy. What I like to do is keep the stock folded. Extend the sling out full length. Throw the sling over the left side of my neck, underneath my right arm. Push the rifle forward. Therefore, creating the length of pull you would get from a regular buttstock like this. It's a very nice gun. It has an American-made barrel, which is a little slightly bigger than the round it shoots. However, I haven't had any problems with accuracy because of that. If you can tell, I'm in the process of painting it right now. The stock here, the top cover, and the muzzle brake, along with the gas tube, have been painted flat black. I just need to finish the rest of the weapon. I also swapped out the lower hand guard with the Russian style one, same as that one. I painted the top one flat black, the same color as these other painted components. Pros on this weapon: it has a folding stock. You can swap out the lower handguard with any AK style handguard. Muzzle brake works very well. Tapco G2 trigger, very nice trigger. Cheap to shoot. Lightweight. You can open the stock for increased accuracy. It's just a really nice gun. The cons are the receiver, the barrel, and the receiver are not original, they're American made. The barrel's slightly bigger. I think it's a 5.56 barrel, I'm not sure, but it is slightly bigger. I did the bullet test. It swallows the bullet all the way up to the neck of the cartridge. However, I haven't had any problems with accuracy because of that. It's very reliable. I'm trying to think of other cons about this weapon. Other than the barrel and the finish being pretty unattractive, this ugly gray color. Those are the two things I don't like about it. Other than that, I really can't complain. I wouldn't have a problem killing somebody with it. Russian Saiga SGL-31-61. Very, very nice. This is as close as you're going to get to a Russian military-issued AK-74. This is as close as you're going to get to it right here. I paid $800 for this one. The pros on this one are Russian receiver, Russian bolt and carrier, Russian piston, Russian barrel. That's why I bought this gun, because I wanted one with an original Russian barrel. AK-74 style compensator. American made though. The finish, beautiful black finish. Very nice finish compared to this. Compared to this ugly ass gray. Cons, the trigger, although Russian military style, is American made. When you pull the trigger, when you're shooting slow, aimed shots, you pull the trigger, the gun goes off. When you slowly release the trigger, right about here, there's an uncomfortable click where it resets or clicks back into place. It's not too comfortable. It doesn't make the weapon feel like a military style weapon at all, or a sporting type weapon with an uncomfortable trigger. However, if you're doing rapid fire, you don't notice it. Another con is this buttstock. I do not like this buttstock at all. I've held this buttstock before, separated from the rifle, just the buttstock itself at the gun show, the same exact one. This is American made, Russian copy. However, since it's American made, it is total shit. After you connect it to the gun, it just feels like shit. It feels like a cheap piece of plastic. Listen. Just fill in this sling, where you connect this sling right here. Just filling it, it feels like cheap pop metal, just cheap shit. It makes a very loud, very unattractive noise. Also, the spring in here, the spring that holds the buttstock cleaning kit, is very, very weak. It's a piece of shit spring. When you put your cleaning kit in there, you have to barely put it in there. If you put it in there with a little bit of force, it'll get stuck. You have to pull the butt plate off, reach the rubber pliers, and yank it out. It's a very shitty spring. They put a very, very crappy spring in here. I've had the Romanian AK and numerous SKSs. The springs on those, very, very strong. You stick it in there, and it's ready to come out as soon as you open up that trap door. The stock feels like shit. Same goes for the handguards. However, this one here is originally made in Russia. I replaced it with an original Russian one. Fuck 922R. The top one is still American, but this one is Russian. The American one that was on this is now on Polish Tantal. Muzzle brake is very effective. Correct barrel diameter. You do the bullet test. Only this much of the bullet goes into it. It doesn't eat it all the way up to the cartridge casing. Pretty accurate. I haven't shot at any pieces of paper with it yet. Just bottles, clay pigeons, set up on the hill. Old lawnmower engines, shit like that. That's all I've shot at. East German magazine wobbles a little bit in here. This magazine does not wobble in Polish Tantal. Bulgarian magazines do not wobble in Russian Saiga. Other pros, this thing is very, very well built. When you take this cover off, it pops right off. You put it on, it snaps right back into place. It's a very nice weapon. I don't think it was worth the $800. I think it's probably worth at the most $600. Polish Tantal, I don't think it was worth the $430. I think at the most it's worth $350. So if we can do $350 for that, we'd be okay. Maybe no more than $600 for this one would be cool. Please, original stock, we'd be fine. That's it.